creative continuity. We bring the convention to you.
Creative continuity in New York, Harold Gant with Jeff Klein. Could you run us through all the animes that you happen to work on?
If I can, let's see.
Here we go.
I'll try to do it in reverse order.
All right.
So Transformers Robots in Disguise.
Right.
Transformers Rescue Bots. Transformers Prime.
Wow.
G.I. Joe Renegades.
Wow.
My Friends Tigger and Pooh. Jackie Chan Adventures. Dragon Tales. Men in Black the Series. Roughnecks the Starship Trooper Chronicles.
Jeez.
Max Steel. Jumanji. Godzilla. Extreme Ghostbusters. Harold and the Purple Crayon.
Oh my God.
Oh, Big Guy and Rusty the Boy Robot.
You worked on so many hit animated shows.
Yes.
Some so groundbreaking, they shaped so many other cartoons in the 90s, even up till now.
Oh, you're very kind.
So why did you jump into comic books?
I lived in Los Angeles for about 25 years, mm-hmm. and my daughter was turning 5, Darby, the Darby of Darby Pop, who is Darby Pop Publishing, Darby Pop Productions, those are my companies.
Right.
And my wife and I decided we really wanted to raise her on the East Coast, not the West Coast. So it became about, how can I keep doing the kind of stuff I love to do, creating characters, working with artists from 3,000 miles away from Los Angeles? And the answer was, maybe comic books. A lot of my guys who work in animation with me also do comics on the side. A lot of my writer friends in movies and television have written the books we're publishing. Mm-hmm. So it's a way for me to keep doing stuff and not have to be in LA anywhere near as often from 3,000 miles away. Storytellers got to tell stories. It's kind of the way it works.
All right. So you didn't want to be on the West Coast because you didn't want to be?
Because my daughter, people do it really successfully all the time, but I grew up on the East Coast, so raising a family on the West Coast seemed impossible to me.
Oh, okay.
I wanted to keep her a little younger, a little longer. So we live in Southern Maine, and she stays a little younger, a little longer.
Okay, okay. And you say you've been doing this for 25 years.
I've been doing this for 25 years. I've done about 1,000 episodes of animated television.
Oh, wow.
And I moved to Maine in 2008 thinking, this was my plan, by the way. It didn't work exactly.
Right.
Because like 6-8 months later, I thought I was going to Hasbro for a month to do the new Transformers series, mm-hmm. which became Prime. And I ended up being bi-coastal for 5 years doing 3 different Transformers series and a G.I. Joe and a bunch of other stuff for them. So I finally got home full-time to Maine starting in April of this year. My first summer home.
Wow. Now, what was the first comic you worked on?
The first book we did was a book called Indestructible, which is a book I wrote.
Right.
Basically, the story is, in a world where superheroes are real, it stands to reason they'd be treated like A-list celebrities.
Right.
A regular guy, is mistaken for being one briefly, gets a taste of that life, decides he likes it, and is pressured into pretending to be a superhero. But how do you do that when you have no powers and the bad guys can kill you?
Wow, I like that. And where'd you go from there?
So we've done 10 issues of that book so far. The next book we did was a book called City by a writer friend of mine named Eric Garcia, who wrote Matchstick Men, the Nick Cage movie, and Repo Men with Jude Law. And that's a thriller set in San Francisco where a company's hired to connect all the security cameras in the city for an anti-terrorism database, mm-hmm. but the computer can't tell real crime from kids playing cops and robbers, so a human is unwittingly merged with the machine.
Wow.
That's Eric Garcia. Then we're doing a book called The Seventh Sword, 7 issues of that, Samurai versus Robots in Space, written by John Raffa, who wrote Dragon, the Bruce Lee movie. Then we did a book called Doberman, written by Martyr and Roselle, who are the guys from It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
Right.
80s Stallone cop in today's LAPD. Fantastic book.
Wow, I think that's poster right there.
That's Cobra right there. Exactly.
All right.
Doberman. And then we dropped a book called Dead Squad with Fetterman and Skaya, who are on Limitless right now, the TV series. And they wrote Ghost Recon for Michael Bay. 3 special ops guys are murdered while they're on a mission. The government reanimates them for 24 hours to complete the mission, but while they were dead, they discovered they're going to hell, and they don't really want to go back there. So how do they change that in 24 hours?
This is brilliant stuff.
Then we got a book called Sidekicked that actually we had exclusively for the con. The book doesn't drop for another couple of weeks. We sold out of all 120 that we brought about 2 hours ago. That's basically the sidekicks get fed up with the egotistical heroes and go on strike.
Right.
And then January, we drop a book called Dead Man's Party. A hitman is just told he's not going to live much longer, puts out a hit on himself so he can go out with a little glory, and discovers that was all a lie, and he can't call off the hit. So now he's got to fight all the best hit people in the world to save his own life.
Wow.
And we got a bunch more coming after that.
Right.
So again, I get to keep doing the stuff I love,
with
a lot of the people I love to work with, and some new people. I'm still going to do animation, and I can't give it up, but I can be home a little more often doing this stuff.
Right. That's awesome. That's awesome. But you're bringing something new and something fresh.
I hope so. And a lot of people in comic books do it because they're trying to break into movies and TV. That's what the goal is for them.
Right.
This is all movie and TV people who just love comic books.
Right.
Which I think is a little different.
Yeah, I see that. I see that. Now, where can we follow you?
If you go to www.darbypop.com, so that's D-A-R-B-Y-P-O-P, mm-hmm. that's our website. We also have links to a Facebook and a Twitter and an Instagram. We love to hear from people. We take submissions. There's a policy on the website, so please check us out. And if you read our stuff, if you like it, if you don't like it, let us know. We always want to hear it.
There's one thing I have to say, and if I'm out of line, just stop me.
Please.
I can't help but notice there's Bruce Lee talk going on over here. What's going on with Bruce Lee?
I am not at liberty to talk about it.
Okay.
But we've been doing, every day at this con, we've had a different Bruce Lee giveaway, and we're probably doing it for a reason.
Right.
I'm not going to tell you what that reason
is. We can't hear the connection yet?
Not yet.
All right.
Maybe soon. But remember, I did Jackie Chan Adventures for
five years.
So I kind of like that world.
Oh my gosh, are you saying there's going to be like an animated Bruce Lee cartoon?
I'm just saying that we're talking about stuff. It's a comic book. Let's start with the comic book.
Okay. All right. I'm getting ahead of myself. Harold Gant, signing off with the legendary Jeff Klein.
You sound so old when you say that.
Sorry, the young and youthful.
I'm going to say it again because that's good.
Harold Gant signing off with a very attractive Jeff Klein.
I find you attractive too.
All right, one more time. Ready?
All right.
I'm glad I put out and action.
Harold Gant signing off with Jeff Klein. Thanks for the interview. America.
Very good.